Hello everyone. So in this video, I'll show you how to configure Valkey, which is an alternative to Redis. So this is my Nextcloud docker-compose file. Here I added a new Valkey service, because before I had Redis running on the host, and it was shared with a Unix socket with a Nextcloud container. Now I moved to Valkey with a docker service like this. And so why should you choose Valkey? It is a fork of Redis, because Redis recently, or last year, changed the license. So now they are not distributing the software under the BSD license, but they are using their own licenses. So there was some concern about that. And the Linux Foundation decided to create this fork, this one here, Valkey. They have their GitHub organization here. In effect, it works the same way as Redis. There aren't many relevant differences, although the Redis team has written this blog post highlighting the differences with the current version of Redis. And it says it can be used for session caching, which is what we're going to use with Nextcloud. Yeah, then there are some of the features we're not going to use and we're not interested in, which are missing from Valkey, but they are in Redis. What you have to do is to create a service like this. So this is the Valkey service, okay? This is the Nextcloud service. So now I migrated to use the .env file. So I can show you the raw file like this without having to use a dummy one. Here I'm using the Valkey Alpine version. Okay, then we're going to see the variables, but what we have to set, which is very important, is the running user group, which must be the same as Nextcloud's, because user 33 is www-data. Otherwise, if you don't set this, Nextcloud is not going to be able to read from the Valkey socket. So this is crucial. Okay, then there is a health check command, the socket directory, its configuration, because we're going to edit the default configuration, so we need to mount it as a volume, as a Docker volume. And then the data directory is because Valkey needs to save the database every once in a while, and without it isn't able to do that, so this is important as well. Okay, so these are the variables I used here and in the Nextcloud service. Anyway, the Valkey command here is it's used to run the Valkey server with a custom configuration file. The health check is just going to check if the server is running via the socket. So Valkey CLI, then you pass the socket path and you run the ping. So this is going to be this command here. Okay, it's going to be replaced. Then of course you need the, as I said before, the configuration file and the data directory. If you do like this, you can see, okay, the configuration file is here. This one is the configuration file. It's very simple, because since we have to use the socket, you can put port 0, so it defaults only to use the socket, not the TCP connection. Here I added 777, but I think it's too permissive. Maybe something like 770 would work, but I didn't try that yet. This is important because it's the path of the Unix socket inside the container. And the last thing you need to do is to change the path of the volume here, of the socket volume, of the socket file. Because in Nextcloud it remains the same as before, var run redis.sock, but now since we have Valkey and we are using a Docker container, we need to redirect it to the correct place like this. So this value is going to be replaced here. Okay, the Redis host and port of course remain the same, because we didn't change them, okay? The Nextcloud container expects them in the same place as before. So the Nextcloud service remains identical. Maybe you can add depends on condition like this. So Nextcloud is not going to start unless Valkey is ready and healthy. Okay, so this is can be useful. Mostly that's it. It's quite simple in, okay. Before signing off, I can show you the output of Valkey. So you just do docker-compose logs Valkey. Okay, so it's working. Yeah, this warning I think we don't need to worry about the memory overcommit warning for the moment. But yeah, it works fine the same way as Redis on the host. Is even simpler to handle because now I can have for each Docker service, I can have its Valkey container connected and not using the one on the host. But yeah, I think it's all for today. And if you have any doubts, there is the old video of Nextcloud configuration with Redis, which I'll put up here. If you found the video useful, leave a thumbs up and subscribe. And as always, bye-bye.